Welcome. In this video, we'll see the SFRs that are used for controlling and configuring the timers in 8051. So among that, first SFR is TMOD SFR. So the format of that TMOD SFR is as shown in the figure. So here we have TMOD register is of 8-bit register. Then the upper 4 bits of TMOD SFR are related to timer 1 and lower 4 bits are related to timer 0. So the MSB bit, that is gate bit, is used for controlling the starting or stopping of the timer using an external signal. So use of this gate bit we have seen in the previous video. Then next bit is C/T bar. This bit is used to decide whether the timer will operate as a timer or timer will operate as a counter. If this bit is 0, it means that the timer will act as a timer and internal clock pulses will be given to the timer register and it will increment the timer register on every clock pulse. Then if this bit is 1, then it means that we are going to operate the timer as a counter. So in counter, we have to give the external clock pulses as the input to the timer. So those clock pulses will be given on the T0 bit for timer 0 and T1 bit for timer 1. Next bit is M1 and next bit is M0. So this M1 and M0 are used to decide the mode of operation of the timer. Now there are 4 different modes available. So out of that, for timer 1 we have 3 modes and for timer 0 we have 4 modes. So the modes are decided with the help of M1 and M0 bits. If both these bits are 0, it means that the mode 0 will be selected and timer will be a 13-bit timer counter mode. If bits are 0, 1, then mode 1 will be selected, in which the timer will be used as a 16-bit timer counter mode. Then if the bits are 1, 0, then the mode 2 of timer will be selected and it is the auto reload mode. And the last mode is available only for timer 0. This mode is not available for timer 1. So that last mode is 2 8-bit split timers. So we can split the 16-bit timer into 2 8-bit timers and we can operate these timers separately. So this is the format of TMOD SFR. So same bits are available for timer 0 as well as for timer 1. So using these upper 4 bits, we can configure timer 1, and using these lower 4 bits, we can configure timer 0. Next SFR is TCON SFR. So using this SFR also, we can control the timer 0 as well as timer 1. So TCON SFR is having upper 4 bits related to timer 0 and timer 1, whereas the lower 4 bits are related to the external interrupts. So these lower four bits we have seen in the previous video related to interrupts. So in this video, we'll just concentrate on the upper 4 bits which are related to timer 0 and timer 1. So the MSB bit is TF1. So this is the timer 1 overflow flag bit. So generally this bit is 0, but whenever the timer 1 overflows, at that time this bit will become 1 to indicate that the overflow has occurred. Next bit is TR1 bit. So this bit is used to start the timer 1. So whenever we want to start the timer, we have to make this bit 1. And whenever we want to stop the timer, we have to make this bit 0. Next bit is TF0. So this is the overflow flag bit for timer 0. So whenever timer 0 overflows, it will be indicated by this flag bit. So this flag bit will become 1 to indicate the overflow has occurred. And generally this flag bit will be 0. The last bit is TR0. So this is related to timer 0. Whenever this bit is 0, it means that the timer 0 will be stopped. And whenever this bit is 1, it means that the timer will keep on counting. So this is about the TCON SFR, which is used for controlling the starting and stopping of the timer. And also it has the overflow flag bits of both the timers. Next, the signal source selection of timer 0 is done in this way. Here we have two paths. for providing the clock to the timer 0. So this diagram is specifically for timer 0. So the clock source that is selected as an input to the timer is decided with the help of this bit called as CT bar, which is present in TMOD SFR. So if this bit is 0, then it will act as a timer, and this switch will be connected to this upper part. In this upper part, the CPU clock is generated using this crystal, and the same clock is given as input to the timer. Whereas if this CT bar bit is equal to 1, it means that this switch will be connected to this line, which is connected to pin P3.4. So whenever we give any clock signal on this pin, that clock signal will be given as input to the timer, and the timer will increment based on the clock which is available on this pin. So that is called as the counter mode. So this clock source selection decides whether we are going to operate the timer as a timer or we are going to operate the timer as a counter. Next is the run stop control of the timer 0. So here again in this diagram we can see the circuit which helps to start or stop the timer. So this upper part decides the mode of operation of the timer, whether it will act as a timer or it will act as a counter, whereas this lower part of the circuit decides whether the timer will start counting or whether the timer will stop counting. So in this table we can have different conditions. For example, the first one is TR0 bit. This bit is used to start or stop the timer. So if this bit is 0, and irrespective of the status of gate bit and P3.2 pin, the timer will be in stop condition. So don't care about these conditions. If this bit is 0, that is TR0 bit is 0, then the timer will in the stop state. Next, if suppose TR0 bit is 1, gate bit is 0, and P3.2 is don't care, then the timer will be in run state. So in this condition, the timer will be controlled by the internal bit called as TR0 bit. Next condition is TR0 is 1, gate bit is 1, and P3.0 is 0. Now in this condition, the timer is going to be controlled by the external signal available on P3.2 pin. That is because this gate bit is 1. So whenever this bit is 1, the starting or stopping of the timer will be decided on the based on the signal available on P3.2 pin. So if that signal is 0, then again the timer will be in stop state. And the final condition is that all these bits are 1, that is TR0 is 1, gate is 1, and P3.2 is 1, then the timer will start counting. So that circuit is implemented using these logic gates which help to start or stop the timer. The next video we'll see the modes that are available in timer 0 as well as timer 1. For more information, you can log on to the website given in the description of this video. Thank you.